So here's a recap of sneaker news over this past week. And first one up, which is something that I missed off earlier in the week, is the Puma Speedcat OG. And this is coming out on the 12th of October. And it's one of those sneakers that seems to be in fashion at the moment. And I think Puma's coming into a little bit of a trend. And what I will say is I do like the brown pair. I've never had a pair of these, and I'd be interested in checking them out. They are low profile sneakers, which are in fashion at the moment. And you know, a range of different sneakers are, I suppose, selling or selling out. Obviously the Adidas ones, and seems to be Puma on that trend as well, and then also Asics. So I'll be, you know, looking to see whether I can grab a pair of these, especially the brown pair, which I really like. And then something that I'm not too much of a fan of is the Edison Chen Clot Adidas Superstar. And for me, this is not something that I would wear, in all honesty. It's more of a fashion shoe, I guess, and you know, using the Superstar as a basis. But I do like the, I suppose, the effort and, you know, the amount of you know, attention that's gone into it in terms of the materials. It looks really nice, but in that sense. But I think for me, it's just too out there and not something that I would personally wear. And then also what's releasing on the 16th of October, and I thought I'd mention it because it's a new model that's coming out from New Balance, and it's the 740. This is kind of like an in-between model between a 530 and I suppose the 1906R or the 2002R. And it has absorb in the midsole. And the look of it, like I said, it's got more of a 1906 type vibe to it with the lines all over it. However, I'm not a fan of this particular sneaker. I'm not sure, there's something about it that I'm not completely sold on. And on the 18th of October, there is this Chris Brown Nightcrawler Nami Slides. Just not a fan of these. There's a blue colorway and this purple colorway, but for me, it's not something that I'm feeling. I just think they just look a bit too out there again for me. And normally I don't mind, you know, sneakers or pieces of footwear that are out there, but this is just a bit too much for me. And then next up, we've got this Bricks and Wood New Balance 1906U, which is more the utility model with the ripstop material on there. Just not a fan of these. I think taking the original 1906R as, you know, as a sneaker and changing the upper to make them more simpler in terms of its overlays just makes it look weird. I'm not too much, you know, I suppose, fond of the colorway, but the overall shape of the shoe just makes it look really boxy and just, yeah, just not a fan of them. I think the original 1906Rs just look nicer to me. And also releasing in October, and just kind of announced out of nowhere, which is usually what Adidas tend to do, is the Ding Yang Zhang Adidas Kuza. So Ding Yang Zhang is one of the Yeezy designers, and to me, this is another one of those weird out there sneakers. Obviously, you know, with all these types of sneakers, you know, love to sort of try them to see how they are, but it just looks, again, a bit too freaky for me. And then also on the 24th of October, we've got the Nike Air Force One Low, which is a Jason's mask, and it's the Halloween version. So it's a one of those sneakers that's quite sort of subtle. I'm not like mad at it, and I think out of all the Halloween releases, this is probably the one that's easier to pull off, and also, you know, giving that sort of slight nod to Halloween. So for me, it's you know, a cool looking sneaker, but not obviously something that I would personally grab, but I can understand why people would gravitate towards this. And then on the 24th of October, we've got the Wales Bonner 4 collection from Adidas. And this is a combination of different sneakers, and it's got two different Sambas, the brown and the blue, and then also the Samba WM, I think it's called, and they are a slightly sort of modified version of the original Samba with a better midsole and outsole combination. And just not a fan of those particular models. I think the one that's outstanding or standing out to me is the Superstar version. I think even though it's got that croc skin all over all of the sneakers, I think the standout for me is the Superstar one. I'm not a fan of the Samba sneaker in general. And there's something that I am a big fan of in October, supposed to be releasing anyway, is the Bad Bunny Messi Adidas Gazelle. I expect these to probably be limited in all honesty, but I've been wearing my original pair of Benito sneakers that I've got, which is the white pair. and they're really comfortable actually. And you know, so far the insole hasn't bottomed out. They just feel very nice on foot, and also just like wearing them because they look cool as well. So this one I think will be definitely on my hit list to grab, but whether I actually, you know, get them or not, it's a different story. But I do really like the colorway. And then on the 11th of November, we've got the Air Jordan 11 Bread Velvet. This looks like you need some sort of baby lotion on the skin. It just looks a bit cracked and a bit dry. But I think it's to do with the exposure of the photo when it was taken. But for me, I'm just not a fan of the velvet, in all honesty. Obviously, it's a women's shoe, so, and you know, it's more sort of skewed towards that. But for me personally, just rather have the original breads, in all honesty. And then in holiday 2024, I actually like this colorway, the New Balance 991 V2. Not to say that I'd pay full price for them, but I do really like this colorway because it's neutral and quite sort of simple with a little bit of hit of orange. Just works really, really well in my opinion. And then also in spring 2025, we're going to have the Air Jordan 4 RM Pine Green. Obviously, this is taking a nod from the SB version, and I don't mind it personally. I think it's nice, but I think for me, this particular one is the GS version, so it obviously looks a bit different in terms of its shape and structure. But you know, the overall execution of the colorway, you know, it's nice in my opinion. You know, I'm not mad at it, and I think you know, the Jordan 4 RMs are probably an underrated model in my opinion as well, because I've been wearing my Nigel Sylvester grey pair, and they actually feel nice on foot. Once you know you've worn them a couple of times, they feel quite nice, and especially because they're low cut as well, makes it easier to wear. And in spring 2025, we've got the Air Jordan 4 RM as well in the Bruce Lee colour. This one I'm not too much of a fan of. It's just me personally, I'm just not a fan of these, you know, sort of yellow and black sneakers. But obviously, you know, each to their own. Some people may love this, but for me personally, I'm just not a fan of that particular colourway. But I do like the Jordan 4 RM, which I mentioned earlier. And then also was broken by sneaker files in terms of the news. So the Air Jordan 5 Fire Red colorway is coming out in fall 2025. And this is a pair that was worn by Michael Jordan, and it has the black tongue on it. And this one I actually really like. I think the problem for me is with the Jordan 5s in general, they just feel a bit bulky around the ankle collar, and that's the reason why I don't like wearing them. But maybe if they, you know, shave off some of that ankle collar padding, you know, if it's something that I might be interested in, because I do like the execution with the 23 on the side. And then also in 2025, we've got the Air Jordan 12 French Blue, and this is another OG release, and I'm not mad at them. And Jordan 12 is not my favourite model, but again, you know, being an OG colourway, I don't think you can be mad at these, and I do like white and blue anyway. And then also in 2025, we've got the Air Force One Star, and this one's quite unique. It's similar to, I suppose, an SB in terms of the materials do something different. So in the sneaker at the front on the Mudguard has a reflective material on it, so in the night it sort of sparks up almost like a silvery color as well, which is quite cool. Obviously I'm not a fan of the sneaker in terms of overall how it looks, but you know, just to sort of add that little bit of hidden detail is quite nice. And then also in 2025, there's a Up There collab with New Balance, which is on the 860 V2. And this particular model I'm not a fan of, in all honesty. I'm not a fan of the 860 V2. I think it's like a cheaper brethren to the 2002R and 1906R. But you know, this collab as well is just not doing it for me in terms of the colorway either. But it's you know, it's an okay model. And then a difference that the, you know, collab version makes compared to the GR version, obviously, you know, you have to see better photos for this, but at the moment this is a Jordan Flight Court in the baby blue color. So I have sort of spoken about this particular model before. I think it's you know, a nice model. The ones that we saw with the collab, and they seem to be, you know, a lot nicer in terms of how they look, and because they had like the embroidered details. But this one, I don't know whether it's the shape or the photos that's been taken, it just looks a little bit off to me. So I'm not sure. You know, hopefully, you know, the model does actually look better than it actually is on this particular photo. And then in holiday 2025, what's rumored to release is the Off-White Air Jordan 1 High OG in Europe. This is the white colorway that released in Europe in limited numbers. I think, you know, one of these things with this off-white stuff, there's a whole bunch of rumors flying around. Obviously, the brand overall has been sold to another company, and you know, that could maybe kickstart another sort of Nike partnership collaboration. And to be confirmed in terms of the release date is the Cecilie Benson A6 GL Terrain. And there's sort of two different types of versions of this. One looks more for, you know, for men, and the other one looks like more for females. And they're both kind of average again to me, just not something that I'm interested in. But, you know, obviously there are people out there who like this kind of stuff. And also another average sneaker in my eyes is the Nike Zoom Vomero Rome in Black Rose colorway, which is a, you know, I think they've just taken the Vomero as a sneaker and just, you know, because it's popular at the moment, just made a more rugged version, which I'm not a fan of at the moment. Obviously, seeing them in hand, it, you know, tells a different story. And also to be confirmed is the Nike Kobe 5 Draft Day. And this is, you know, one of those sneakers that I kind of saw, you know, in terms of its leaked photos a few days ago. And to be honest, I'm not that impressed. This is another one that was released by SneakerFast. But to me, it just looks very average, in all honesty. This is probably like the first Kobe that I've seen where I'm just like not too much of a fan of, you know, and just looks very, very basic.